Oscillators, also called A-stable multivibrators, are frequently used in electronic equipment to generate continuous waveforms of a specific frequency using only DC inputs. The generated frequencies are used to synchronize digital logic and storage devices such as latches and flip-flops. There are many different types of oscillators. This video deals with so-called relaxation oscillators. Relaxation oscillators can be built by using an inverting Schmitt trigger, followed by an RC low-pass filter. The filtered signal is fed back to the Schmitt trigger input. We already talked about Schmitt triggers in one of our other videos. Let us have a look at what happens in one time period. We assume that our inverting Schmitt trigger just switched to high, and that our input, which is the voltage over the capacitance, is zero. As our Schmitt trigger outputs the supply voltage, we charge our capacitance by the exponential function that we already know from the capacitor charging equation. The time constant tau is defined as R times C. The starting voltage Vc at t equal to zero is 0 volt, and after an infinite amount of time, the capacitance Vc at t towards infinity would be charged to the supply voltage. However, the capacitor is not fully charged, as the upper threshold voltage of the Schmitt trigger is reached and the inverting Schmitt trigger's output goes from high to low. This means that the capacitor starts to discharge. Again, we can use our known capacitor charging equation, whereas starting voltage is the upper threshold voltage and the target voltage is the lower supply voltage. Again, the discharging part stops when the lower threshold voltage of the Schmitt trigger is reached. This initiates the charging part again with a slightly different formula than before, as we do not start at 0 volt, but at the lower threshold voltage. But now that we have the charging and discharging formulas, how can we calculate the period or the frequency? We simply have to rewrite our equation in terms of the time t and insert the capacitor voltage at time t, which is either the lower or upper threshold voltage, the voltage the capacitor tends to be charged to, which is either the upper or lower supply voltage, the voltage when the Schmitt trigger is switching again. So Vc of t equals t1 or t2. Which is the upper or lower threshold voltage, depending on whether the capacitor is charged or discharged. In this way, we get the on and off time of the relaxation oscillator. Even though we always have the same RC low-pass filter, and therefore the same time constant tau, this must not necessarily mean that the on and off times are the same. These times are depending on the upper and lower threshold voltages of our Schmitt trigger. If the threshold voltages are symmetrical with regard to the upper and lower supply voltages, the on and off times are the same. If the threshold voltages are not symmetrical, then also the on and off times are not the same. The period is simply the sum of on and off times, and the frequency is the inverse of the period. Let us try to calculate an example. We have a supply voltage of 5 volt and threshold voltages of the Schmitt trigger at 1 and 3 volt. The resistance is given by R equals 1 kilo ohm and C equals 1 microfarad. The time constant, therefore, is tau equals R times C equals 1 millisecond. For the first calculation, the voltage at time t equals 0 is 0 volt, and the RC structure is tending to 5 volt. Now we want to know the time when the voltage reaches the upper threshold voltage of 3 volt. The oscillator reaches the upper threshold voltage after 0.916 milliseconds. For the discharging, we are starting at the upper threshold voltage, and the RC structure is tending towards the lower supply voltage, which is 0 volt. We want to know the time when the voltage reaches the lower threshold voltage. We reach the lower threshold voltage after 1.099 milliseconds, which corresponds to the off time. Now we start at the lower threshold voltage, and the RC structure is tending towards the positive supply voltage. Again, we want to know the time when we reach the upper threshold voltage. This is happening after 0.693 milliseconds, which is the on time. Summing the discharging and charging times, this leads to a period of t equals 1.792 milliseconds and a frequency of f equals 558 Hz. In this video, we have talked about the basic structure of relaxation oscillators, shown its working principle, derived formulas to mathematically describe its behavior, and calculated the on and off times, period and frequency of the oscillator. We cover ring oscillators and other types of multivibrators in our other videos. I'm Sophia with the Institute of Electronics. We hope you've learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.